After completion of available energy topic, we will cover the thermodynamic relation. The thermodynamic relations. In this one, we will first of all see some mathematical theorems. The theorem number one, we will see if dz is equal to mdx plus ndy is exact, it is possible only when the partial derivative of m with respect to y, when x as a constant will be equal to the partial derivative of n with respect to x when y as a constant. That is the theorem number one, and I'll write equation number one. Again, I'll see the theorem number two. If the function f is the function of x, y, and z, then the derivative of x with respect to y, derivative of y with respect to z, and derivative of z with respect to x will be equal to 1. I'll write it as equation 2. And after that, I'll write the theorem number 3. In which we will see if z is the function of x and y, then derivative of x with respect to y, having z as a constant, derivative of y with respect to z, having x as a constant, derivative of z with respect to x, having y as a constant, will be equal to minus 1. That is theorem number 3. I'll write it as equation 3. The topic, first we will start with the topic of Maxwell equation. Maxwell equations. The first we will start TDS, or combine first law of and second law of thermodynamic, that is equal to dU plus PdV. And dU will be equal to TDS minus PdV. This will be exact or property of a system when derivative of temperature with respect to volume, when entropy is a constant, will be equal to derivative of pressure with respect to entropy when volume as a constant. That will be written as first Maxwell equation. We will see again the combined first law and second law of thermodynamic in the term of enthalpy. That will be equal to minus VdP, or dH will be equal to TdS plus VdP is exact when derivative of temperature with respect to pressure, when entropy is a constant, will be equal to derivative of volume with respect to entropy when pressure is a constant. This is known as Maxwell's second equation. Again, we know that the Gibbs function G is given by H minus TS. Or you can write the differential of G will be equal to dH minus TdS minus STdT. This value will be equal to dH minus TdS will be equal to VdP minus STdT. is exact when dv upon dt when p is a constant will be equal to minus of derivative of x with respect to p when t as a constant. This is Maxwell's third equation. This equation is Maxwell's third equation. Again, we know the Helmholtz function f is equal to u minus ts, or you can write df is equal to du minus tds minus s into dt. This value will be equal to minus pdv minus s into dt. So, the derivative of pressure with respect to temperature when volume is constant will be equal to derivative of entropy with respect to volume when temperature is constant. It is known as Maxwell's fourth equation. So, if we will write all fourth equation of the Maxwell, then first equation will be del T by del V when X is a constant will be equal to minus del P by del S when V is a constant. That is first Maxwell equation, and second Maxwell equation will be equal to del T by del P when S entropy as a constant will be equal to del volume upon del S when P is a constant. Other two Maxwell equation will be equal to del V upon del T when pressure is a constant will be equal to minus ds del S upon del P when temperature is a constant. That is third Maxwell equation. And fourth Maxwell equation will be equal to del P upon del T when volume is a constant is equal to del S upon del V when T as a constant. These are the four Maxwell equations. After completion of Maxwell equation, we will see the TdS diagram or the TdS equation. We will see the TdS equation, temperature entropy equation. From the equation of entropy change, we have found entropy is the function of temperature and volume, and it is also a function of temperature and pressure. If we have to find the change of entropy, that will be given as change or derivative of entropy with respect to temperature when volume is constant into dt plus derivative of entropy with respect to volume when temperature is constant is into dv. And TdS will be equal to ds upon dt, T ds upon dt volume is constant into dt plus T ds upon dv into dv. We know that dt upon ds at constant volume is equal to T upon CV and ds upon dv when temperature is constant will be equal to dp upon dt when volume is constant. Substituting the values in the equation, we will find TdS will be equal to CV into dt plus T dv upon dt when volume is constant into dv. That is the first TdS equation. It is known as first TdS equation. TdS equation. Again, when we will consider the entropy is the function of temperature and pressure, then change of entropy will be equal to change of entropy with respect to temperature when pressure is constant into dT plus change of entropy with respect to pressure when temperature is constant into dP. Or TdS will be equal to T into dS upon dT, pressure is constant into dP, plus T into dS upon dP when temperature is constant into dP. But again we know that dT over dS in the constant pressure process will be equal to T upon Cp and dS upon dP in constant temperature process is equal to dV upon dT having pressure as a constant, that will be with minus sign. So substituting the values in equation, we will find TdS is equal to Cp into dT minus d dV over dT P into dP. It is known as second TdS equation. After the completion of TdS equation, we will find the energy of an ideal gas. The energy of an ideal gas according to the combined first law and second law of thermodynamics, we have seen that dO is equal to TdS minus PdV, and substituting the value of TdS from the first equation, we will see the first TdS equation, TdS is equal to Cv into dT plus T dP over dT when volume is constant into dV minus P into dV, energy of any substance can be written as dT plus T dP over dV when volume is constant minus P into dV. That is generalized energy equation. This is generalized energy equation. But till now you have studied only the dO is equal to Cv dT. But right now that is a complete equation of the internal energy. Now we will see what you have studied till now. For an ideal gas, you will see PV is equal to MRT. PV is equal to MRT. Just differentiate the equation with respect to temperature when volume is a constant. dP over dT will be equal to, when volume is a constant, will be equal to MR upon V, and MR upon V is nothing but PyT. Just substituting the value of dV upon dT at constant volume process in the equation of energy, we will find Cv into dT plus T into P over T minus P into dV. Oh my god, this value is equal to 0. It means the change of internal energy will be equal to Cv dT plus 0. It means internal energy will be equal to Cv dT. It is only valid for an ideal gas. The internal energy will be equal to Cv dT. It's an important result, so I'll highlight this point. This is only valid for an ideal gas. Now we will see the enthalpy of a gas. Again we will see what will be the enthalpy of a gas. We know that according to the combined first law and second law of thermodynamic, dH will be equal to TdS plus VdP. Now substituting the value of the TdS from the second TdS equation, this value will be equal to Cp dT minus T dV over dT at constant pressure into dP plus VdP. Now the dH or the enthalpy of any substance will be written as Cp into dT minus T dV upon dT at constant pressure minus V into dP. This is the value of the enthalpy for any substance. I'll write this is the equation A. Again, for an ideal gas, we know VV is equal to MRT, or dV upon dT when pressure is constant will be equal to MR upon P. This value will be equal to V upon T. Just substituting the value of V, value of this than A. dH or change of enthalpy for an ideal gas will be equal to Cp into dT minus T into V by T minus V into dP. So the change of enthalpy for an ideal gas will be equal to Cp into dT. Oh, you will see here it is only valid for an ideal gas. It means you write the change of enthalpy is equal to Cp into dT. It is valid only for an ideal gas. I'll just highlight this point. This equation is valid only for an ideal gas. This equation is valid only for an ideal gas. Now again we will write the change of internal energy is equal to Cv into dT plus T into dP upon dT at constant volume minus pressure into dB. If we will see the equation, we will see the internal energy is the function of temperature as well as volume. It means the change of internal energy will be equal to change of internal energy with respect to temperature when volume is constant into dT plus the change of internal energy with respect to volume when temperature is constant into dV. Just if we will compare the term first and second term from the equation 1 and equation 2, we will see the du will be du over dv with respect to volume and temperature each constant will be equal to T dP upon dT when volume is constant minus P. But for an ideal gas, the value of T into dP upon dT when volume is constant minus P will be equal to 0. Just now we have proved. So the change of internal energy with respect to volume when temperature is constant will be equal to 0. It means for an ideal gas, internal energy is not a function of volume. So again we can consider internal energy may be the function of temperature, pressure and volume, or again in the other words we can write temperature will be the function of internal energy, pressure and volume. applying the theorem number 2, we will see the derivative of internal energy with respect to pressure, temperature is constant. Derivative of pressure with respect to volume, temperature is constant. Derivative of volume with respect to internal energy is constant when temperature is constant will be equal to 1. Or derivative of internal energy with respect to pressure when temperature is constant into derivative of pressure with respect to volume when temperature is constant will be equal to du upon dv when temperature is constant. But now we have proved du upon dv is equal to 0. But dp upon dv when temperature is constant it not equal to 0. So du upon dp when temperature is constant is equal to 0. It means you can say for an ideal gas internal energy is not a function of pressure. It is not a function of pressure for an ideal gas. So from both the result it is clear that internal energy U is independent from volume and pressure. It means internal energy is only function of temperature. It may vary with temperature. It is called as Joule's law. It is called as Joule's. So U is only function of temperature. U is only function of temperature. That is important relation. The next topic is coefficient of volume expansion, that is your beta. It shows the variation of volume with respect to temperature under isobaric process. So the beta coefficient of volume expansion will be given by change of volume with respect to temperature when pressure is constant. And the second relation is isothermal compressibility, that is K. Isothermally compressibility. It is a simple, so the variation of volume with respect to pressure when temperature is constant. In this one, minus sign indicate indicates the variation of volume and pressure is opposite. The next topic is difference between Cp and Cv. Difference between Cp and Cv. Now we will compare the first TdS equation and second TdS equation. Then we will see the first TdS equation Cv dt plus T into del P upon del T when volume is constant into dV is equal to Cp into dt minus T into del V upon del T when pressure is constant into dP. T del V upon del T when pressure is constant into dP plus T del P upon del T when volume is constant into dP is equal to Cp minus Cv into dT. So dT will be equal to T upon
Cp minus Cv dV upon dt when pressure is constant into dP plus T upon Cp minus Cv dP upon dt when volume is constant into dV. That is your equation 1. And again, T, from the equation it is clear T is the function of pressure as well as it is the function of volume. So dT or the change of temperature will be equal to derivative of temperature with respect to pressure when volume is constant into dP plus derivative of temperature with respect to volume when pressure is constant into dV. This is equation 2. Now comparing the equation 1 and 2, the equation 1 and 2, del T upon del P with respect to volume will be equal to T Cp minus Cv into del V upon del T when pressure is constant. So Cp minus Cv is equal to T del V upon del T when pressure is constant into del P upon del T when volume is constant. This one number 3. Now again, if we will see the theorem number 2, that will say when temperature is the function of pressure and volume, then del P upon del V when temperature is constant will be equal to del V upon del T when pressure is constant will be multiply by del T upon del P when volume is constant is equal to minus 1 from theorem number 2. Then del P upon del V, del P upon del T, del T when volume is constant will be equal to minus del V upon del T when pressure is constant multiply with the del P upon del V when temperature is constant. I'll write this one as equation 4. So the substituting the value of del P by del T when volume is constant in equation 3, we will find Cp minus Cv is equal to minus T dV upon dT when pressure is constant whole square into del P upon del V when temperature is constant. I'll write this one as equation 5. For an ideal gas, t is positive and del v upon del t at constant pressure is square is also positive, but del p upon del v when the temperature is constant in general case will be negative. It means simply you can say the Cp minus Cv will be greater than zero. Cp minus Cv will be greater than zero, or you can say its value will be positive. So the Cp will be higher than Cv. It is most important point which you have just seen. Always you write Cp is greater than Cv, but that is the mathematical expression in which you have found Cp is higher than Cv. From equation 5 we will see del V upon del T at constant pressure is square is equal to beta square into V square, and minus del P upon del V when temperature is constant will be equal to 1 upon K into volume. Substituting the value, the values in equation 5, we will find Cp minus Cv is equal to T V beta square upon K. It is the most important relation in the term of compressibility and coefficient of expansion. Coefficient of expansion, difference between Cp and Cv for an ideal gas. For an ideal gas, you know very well, enthalpy H will be written as U plus PV. And for an ideal gas, H will be equal to MCP into T plus U will be equal to MCV into T, and PV for an ideal gas will be equal to MRT. Substituting the value in the enthalpy equation, you will see MCP into T will be equal to MCV T plus MRT. So Cp minus Cv is equal to R from this equation. It is called as Mayer formula. I'll write this one as an important equation, equation 1. As an important equation, equation 1. The next most important topic of this chapter, Joule Kelvin coefficient. Joule Kelvin coefficient. It is most important chapter of this, most important topic of this chapter for gate point of view. Most of the time a theoretical question has been asked from this topic. The slope of, first point I'll write, the slope of TP diagram on isenthalpic curve, that is H is equal to constant, is known as Joule-Thomson or Joule-Kelvin coefficient. It is given by a letter mu. So the mu will be equal to del T upon del P when enthalpy is constant. Let's consider an example of throttling process. The valve is partially open. So The enthalpy of the entire process, enthalpy of the entire process, process is constant. Now we will see the variation of temperature and pressure. Variation of temperature and pressure from initial point to the final point. If we will see the condition of pressure and temperature, then this, let's consider the initial condition of, that is your I point of the pressure and temperature is this one. At this one, the temperature is Ti and pressure is Pi. Then, first, due to the irreversibility, the temperature is going to increase. Temperature is going to increase, but the pressure of the fluid is going to decrease. But after a certain point, the temperature will going to start decrease because of the expansion. So the final point of the pressure and temperature will be somewhere here. So this will be Tf, Pf. If we will plot the diagram, this diagram will be something like this. This diagram will called as H is equal to constant, or you can say this curve will be called as isenthalpic curve. The slope of this curve is called as Joule Kelvin coefficient mu. By changing the initial value of enthalpy, we will find the number of curve on TP diagram. These curve can be shown as this one is the first curve when the enthalpy H1 is equal to constant. Again, we will increase the value of the enthalpy and remains constant, that we will get the curve after the increasing the value of the enthalpy H2 has a constant. Again, we will see when H3 is equal to constant. Then in each curve, we will see a point, this one A dash and a double dash is the point where the slope of TP diagram is equal to 0. It means if we will plot all the point where the slope of Joule Kelvin coefficient or the slope of TP diagram, where the slope of TP diagram is equal to 0, where mu is equal to 0, it is called as inversion curve. So inversion curve is the curve where the Joule Kelvin coefficient is equal to 0. So the curve at which the Joule Kelvin coefficient is equal to 0 is known as inversion curve. I'll highlight this point, sorry. So if we check the left section of the inversion curve, then we will see the mu is greater than 0 in the left section because the slope of TP diagram is positive. But again, if we'll check the right section of the inversion curve, then we will see the mu is less than 0 or the slope of the right section of the inversion curve is 0, is less than 0. But again we check the left section, the fluid is cooled. It means this portion is called as cooling region. Again this portion, the temperature is going to increase, so this portion is called as heating region. Heating region. It means it is clear where mu is less than 0, the process in that portion is heating process, and again the mu is greater than 0, the process is cooling process. This is less than 0 heating, and this is greater than 0, you can see this is the cooling process. We know that dH is equal to CV into dT minus CP into dT minus T dV upon dT when pressure is constant minus V into dP. But for the isenthalpic process, or for the throttling process, dH will be equal to 0, or you can write CP dT will be equal to T dV over dT when pressure is constant minus V into dP. So dP upon dT when enthalpy is constant will be equal to 1 upon CP T dV upon dT when pressure is constant minus V. This is Joule-Thomson coefficient in the term of pressure, temperature and volume. This is equation 1 for the Joule-Thomson or Joule-Kelvin coefficient topic. For an ideal gas, T dV upon dT at constant pressure minus V, right now we have proved, is equal to 0. So mu will be equal to 0 for an ideal gas. Mu will be equal to 0. So from these results, I'll give you the three important points in which most of the time one or two point has been asked. The first important point, you will see, when mu is less than 0 or mu is negative, the region is heating region. And the second important point I'll give you, when mu is greater than 0, or you can say when mu is positive, the region is, or in cooling region, the mu is positive. The region is cooling region. And the third important point I'll give you, for an ideal gas, the value of mu is equal to 0, or the slope of TP diagram in isenthalpic process, is 0. That is Joule-Thomson coefficient, or that is complete discussion about the Joule-Thomson coefficient. Now with the help of thermodynamic relation, we will see the work done for the open system. We know that del Q will be equal to dH minus VdP. But if we will see the SFE equation, we will see H1 plus 1 Y2 MC1 square plus MG Z1 plus D del Q will be equal to H2 plus 1 by 2 M C2 square plus MG Z2 plus del W. So while neglecting the kinetic energy and potential energy, we will see H1 plus del Q is equal to H2 plus del W, or del Q will be equal to del H dH minus plus del W. That is equation number second, and this one is the equation number first. If we will compare the first and second equation, then we will find del Q for the open system will be equal to minus VdP, or W for the open system will be given as 1 to 2 minus VdP. This will be the work done for the open system, or work done for open system or for steady flow equation. Open system. Now we will find the work done for different process. First process is reversible isobaric process, in which we will see there is no change of volume. So work done del W will be equal to minus BdP. So your work done for the open system will be equal to zero in isobaric process. And two, the work done for the isochoric process or constant volume process, what will be the value of the work done? We will see the work done for the isochoric process will be equal to VdP, or it will be from 1 to 2. The work done will be equal to minus V P2 minus P1. And the third case is work done for the isothermal process. We will see on the PV diagram. On the PV diagram, the isothermal process is an hyperbolic process. So the area of hyperbola on volume axis or pressure axis will be the same. So work done for the open system will be equal to the work done for the closed system. For the closed system in isothermal process, the equation will be the same as the equation for the closed system. For the adiabatic process, we know PV raised to gamma is equal to P1 V1 raised to gamma is equal to P2 V2 raised to gamma is equal to constant. So the work done for the open system will be equal to minus V into dP. And from the equation, just substituting the value of the V, we will find, and after that integrating, we will find the value of the work done will be equal to gamma upon gamma minus 1 into P1 V1 minus P2 V2. Or it can be write as work done for the adiabatic process can be write as gamma upon gamma minus 1 MR T1 minus T2. And gamma upon gamma minus 1 into R is nothing but it is equal to Cp. It is equal to Cp, so W1 to 2 can be written as MCp, MCp T1 minus T2. That will be the work done for the open system in adiabatic process. And again, the work done for the polytropic process, work done for the polytropic process can be written as in the same way, written as for the open system N upon N minus 1 to P1 V1 minus P2 V2, or it can be written as N upon N minus 1 into MR T1 minus T2. This is the work done for the open system for all the process. In this way, your thermodynamic relation topic has been complete.